Hey guys, Hobbs here, and today we're going to look at the XT002 deconstructor. So this is the trash on the way to the deconstructor. A lot of what we've marked in the distance, you'll see those little energy fields, which actually I think they heal them. If anything, they stop damage from going to them. We normally take down the salvage, or the little healing bots, not the salvage bots, but the little humanoid looking bots first, those technicians. And in this case, we actually took them down last. The trash in Ulduar, as you get further in, you'll notice that you do have a lot more crowd control. This is one of the few spots where you can actually use AoE, and as you see, we do have a few dead, so it wasn't 100% successful. Few things to watch in this video, guys. When the heart drops, that's when we're going to actually pop everything we have, try to get it down as fast as possible. In this video, we don't have enough DPS to get it into hard mode as of yet. I'm sure that will come with time and gear. The other thing too is keep an eye, see how he's banging on the ground. He does a tantrum where everybody's health, you'll notice on the right, is dropping. So that's when your healers are going to be wanting to be on the ball and raid heal, and you'll see I've got the light bomb on myself right now. So basically, because I was tanking, everybody moved away from me. The other bomb to watch out for is the gravity bomb. Here's another instance where I have the light bomb, but I'm not tanking in this case. Now this is our 25 man, one of our attempts. Now the gravity bomb is a different one where anybody close to you will get pulled in and do damage. If you watch the guy with the skull on his head, he's got it. It's a purple like aura around him and it pulls in the surrounding players. So sometimes it does happen, especially when characters are newer to it. So having an eye of what to look out for should help the raid, because sometimes if someone's close to you and they have the light bomb or gravity bomb, you can move away as well as if they're not. So in this case, I believe we are 20 manning this one. This is about a month old, this footage, and I will speed this one up because I'm going to show you more recent footage near the end of the video. Of course, the main pull, you know, popping my wings, building up as much aggro as possible. This was also prior to the new talent tree that I'm using. Like always, you can get my armory information off my blog, guys. The thing is, don't be coming over to the server because it is full and we aren't accepting any new members presently in the guild. So as we're watching through this, you'll see different members have light bombs and gravity bombs and they're running away from the other members to make sure that we're all going to stay alive. We do have a few deaths in here. If you watch on the right hand side, I have all our health and everything pulled out onto the screen. The fortunate thing is we do have a druid who can battle res, and you'll see we just lost her lock there and brought her back real fast. We're actually fortunate enough to have three druids. We have two healers and one who's DPSing and who can also quickly turn into a tank if things go awry. The other thing I haven't mentioned is heroic. So we got the heroic achievement for not letting the little heal bots, which I haven't explained yet, but I will in the next fight. I'm going to show you a little bit, guys, before I talk about the little bots that come, about the add-ons I'm using. I'm using X-Loot and X-Loot Master right now. So I announced it to the raid, you know, attention roll 1000. We do have loot council in the guild, so if someone's newer to the raid or doesn't show up very often, we're trying to get our guild further in Tal'Dorei, so we try to put it to the best person possible. I did roll on this ring. I did win the roll, but it wasn't really going to benefit me, so I did hand it off to the other tank. And that's part of loot council, is it's not all about me, me, me. It's about the team and growing as a team. That is a BOE. One other rule that we do carry is on BOEs, we don't give it to off-spec. If it's a BOE for your main spec, well, then we basically will gear up the main spec. If it's not, we'll sell it on the auction house and put it towards our free repairs that I talked about months ago. These shoulders went to our healer. Unfortunately, I didn't get any footage of them, but they're definitely cool looking. And once again, I'll have a link to all the stats on my blog. Everybody on my last video, which was very, very short, said you're tanking them in the wrong location at the stairs, which I just showed. Try tanking them between these two garbage piles or scrap piles, and that way when he summons the adds, the bots, they won't actually summon from those two piles. They'll only summon C from the further away here. And I didn't talk about the bots. You'll notice that bomb one. That bomb one, when it gets to about half health, will explode and do damage to everybody close to it. So we assign range people to actually be on those bots. Then there's the bigger type of bots, which do need to be tanked. In this case, we have two off tanks.
Then you have the small little bots, the healing bots. If they reach the boss, they heal them, and they heal them a lot.
And you'll see, you know, the light bombs are moving out. We are using deadly boss mods as well, guys, which marks it. See, I put an X on top of me. As I'm heading out, you'll see gravity bombs coming in. So that was kind of touchy. It could have did damage to us, but I think we were lucky there. So his heart drops again. You'll see we're all up right now. We do have one guy who's disconnected, and our actual raid healer, and here's where I pick up one of the bots, our raid healer Kargon, he was having connection problems, so we are down one raid healer, so we do lose a few along the way. In this case, I think we only had two druids. No, we still had three, and we're going to be battle resin. Here we lose the tank, so our Death Knight picks it up. And I believe he died, and then our druid, who I talked about earlier, he had actually went into bear form, but then they said, okay, get on the boss, so now I'm going to pick it up. And holding aggro there was difficult, because when I got to him, the heart was down, and so we're damaging the heart, so I wasn't building aggro. And so you'll notice as soon as I got there, he ran away for a bit, but I quickly got it back. This was a pretty intense fight. You'll see by the skeletons on the ground, we have wiped on this before. Even though it was easier and we have more people than in the previous video, for some reason we just weren't on our A game this night. So, you know, this was a pretty intense moment that we didn't want to wipe again. And you'll see he's actually getting quite low now. But everybody's getting spread out in the back, which makes it harder for the raid healers, because now they can only really heal half the party. You're going to see a lot of trees running back and forth. One's way off in the distance, the other guy's, you know, back over here, over there. So we kind of recognized that and brought everybody in. I changed my aura, because when I wasn't tanking, I used my blessing. And not aura, but, you know, the little buff that gets you wisdom back. And I actually changed it to build aggro, but I did it kind of like halfway late. Because when you're not tanking, you're not getting hit, you don't get mana back. So we're getting very close. I pop my shield wall here just to make sure that we get it. I let my healer know in vent that, you know, shield wall's up. My trinket on the right, my dodge trinket, just about to pop, looking good. And I died. Like, I mean, if you rewind that and take a look at my health, it was bam, bam, too little. Like, one big shot, one other. And yes, I do have it at, I think I'm 541 defense. So these shoulders had dropped. I mentioned in the last video really quick. Great looking graphics on them. This little lad here in Kara doesn't realize I'm trying to take a video of them for you guys. One other thing I will show you is this wand. It's such a cool little effect. And when I do get a video of those shoulders that our healer had gotten, I'll put it in one of the future vids. Thanks again, guys, for watching. This is one little achievement I'm going to leave you with. We actually 8-manned regular OS, and it's great going back and doing some of the old achievements that you miss, and now that you got some Alduar gear, you can go back, and Nax is going super fast now for us too as well. Hit the yellow subscribe button. I'll see you again shortly, guys. I'm trying to bring him out sooner for you. Till next time on the Hobbs Way of Pulling.